Here in this video, we are solving a problem from thermal conductivity. The problem is like this. Three different metals having same physical dimensions. So what is most important thing that is given for you is their physical dimensions are same. That means what? All of them have, all three have same length, their length is not different. They also have same area of cross section. So these two points are important to understand. They are connected, of course, as shown. We can see the diagram there. Find the temperature at the junction is what is our question is, right? So you want to find out, you need to find out what is the temperature at this junction. Let me call that temperature as theta. We have to find out theta. Now if you notice little carefully, this rod is having a coefficient of thermal conductivity 3k, this is 2k, this is k. They are different, but their lengths are same, their areas of cross sections are same as per given for you. And if you notice the temperatures little carefully, here the temperature is 50. Here the temperature is 100, here the temperature is 0 degrees centigrade. So the general observation is, this is a place that is hot, and when compared with the remaining parts, heat always tries to flow from hotter to colder, therefore heat will start from here. Now after reaching the junction, it has two ways to go. It will go either this way, a part of it, and another part of that will go this way. So what we can say is, whatever the heat that is developed here between, if I name these junctions as A, B, C, D, what I can say is dq by dt that is coming from A to B after reaching the junction has two ways to go. It will split at the junction as dq by dt between these two junctions B and C, and dq by dt between these junctions B and D. So what is that dq by dt as per the coefficient of thermal conductivity? Dq by dt equal to k a delta theta by L in general. Let us write that general equation in equation number 1 and solve the problem. Dq by dt between the points A and B as k of that part, it is given that k of that part is 3k. Area is uniform A. Delta theta is 100 and theta. So the difference between the temperatures is 100 minus theta. 100 shall be more because heat is flowing there. By L. Let me assume that length is equal to L. Same length L, same area of cross section A. That is between the points AB. Now write between the points BC. Between the points BC, the value of the K is 2K. Area is same. Temperature difference is, this is theta and this is 50. So this must be theta minus 50 by L. Plus, between the points B and D, again the value of the K is there, K itself, A, delta theta is between theta and 0. So theta minus 0 by length is here. Now if you notice little carefully, you can cancel so many things. What are that? L's are same on both the sides, can be cancelled. Areas are same on both the sides, can be cancelled. K also can be cancelled. So what is remaining then in that case? Here 3 is remaining. 100 minus theta equal to, here 2 is remaining, theta minus 50 in this part. Plus here only 1 is remaining, theta minus 0. Simplify this. 300 minus 3 theta equal to 2 theta minus 100 plus theta. 2 theta and theta is 3 theta minus 100 equal to 300 minus 3 theta. Take this 3 theta to other side, 100 to this side. So 300, that minus 100 this side will become a plus 100. Minus 3 theta on the other side becomes a plus 3 theta. So 3 theta and 3 theta is 6 theta. 300 and 100 is 400. That implies theta equal to 400 by 6 or 200 by 3 or 66.6 degree centigrade. This is how we can solve the problem. And while solving the problem, the most important part is this equation. The heat, how do you got that equation? This is a higher temperature when compared with the other temperatures. So heat start passing this way first. After reaching here, it has two ways to go. Simply, heat is conserved. Whatever the heat enters the system at the junction is the heat that leaves the junction. That's a simple concept that we have used to solve the problem, and we got the answer. That's it. Thank you for watching.